pure in heart, rejoice, give thanks, and sing. Your glorious banner wave on high, the cross of Christ your King. Rejoice, 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 give thanks, and sing. With all the angel choirs, with all the saints of earth, pour out the strains of joy and bliss, true rapture, noblest mirth. Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. Your clear hosannas raise, and alleluia's loud, while answering echoes upward float like wreaths of incense cloud. Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. Yes, all through life's long path, still chanting as ye go, from youth to age by night and day, in gladness and in woe. Rejoice, 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 give thanks and sing. Still lift your standard high, still march in firm array, as warriors through the darkness toil, till dawns the golden day. Rejoice,
blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Scott, Bishop in the Church of God, on behalf of the clergy and the people of the Diocese of Fort Worth, we present to you Paula Kaye Jefferson to be ordained a deacon in Christ's Holy Catholic Church.
Has she been selected in accordance with the canons of this church? And do you believe her manner of life to be suitable to the exercise of this ministry?
We certify to you that she has satisfied the requirements of the canons, and we believe her to be qualified for this order.
Paula, will you be loyal to the doctrine, discipline, and worship of Christ as this church has received them? And will you, in accordance with the canons of this church, obey your bishop and other ministers who may have authority over you and your work?
I am willing and ready to do so, and I solemnly declare that I do believe the Holy Scripture of the Old and New Testaments to be the Word of God, and do contain all things necessary for salvation. And I do solemnly engage to conform to the doctrine, discipline, and worship of the Episcopal Church.
Dear friends in Christ, you know the importance of this ministry and the weight of your responsibility in presenting Paula K. Jefferson for ordination to the Sacred Order of Deacons. Therefore, if any of you know any impediment or crime because of which we should not proceed, come forward now and make it known. Is it your will that Paula be ordained a deacon?
It is.
Will you uphold her in this ministry?
We will.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
God the Father,
have mercy on us.
God the Son,
have mercy on us.
God the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
We pray to you, Lord Christ.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church of God, that it may be filled with truth and love and be found without fault at the day of your coming, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of your church and their vocation and ministry, that they may serve you in a true and godly life, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Michael, our presiding bishop, for Scott, our bishop, and for all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be filled with your love and hunger for truth and may thirst after righteousness, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Paula, chosen deacon in your church, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That she may faithfully fulfill the duties of this ministry, build up your church, and glorify your name, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That by the indwelling of the Holy Spirit, she may be sustained and encouraged to persevere to the end, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of her community, that they may be adorned with all Christian virtues, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Christ, that our divisions may cease and that all may be one, as you and the Father are one, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who do not yet believe, and for those who have lost their faith, that they may receive the light of the gospel, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a blessing upon all human labor and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the world may be freed from poverty, famine, and disaster, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves, for the forgiveness of our sins, and for the grace of the Holy Spirit to amend our lives, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the communion of your church, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that, with all the saints, they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Rejoicing in the fellowship of the ever-blessed Virgin Mary, blessed Barnabas, and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord, our God.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of unchangeable power and eternal light, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery. by the effectual working of your providence, carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things which were being cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from Isaiah. Thus says God the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and new things I now declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. Sing to the Lord a new song, his praise from the end of the earth. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the coastlands and their inhabitants. Let the desert and its towns lift up their voice, the villages that Kedar inhabits. Let the inhabitants of Selah sing for joy. Let them shout from the tops of the mountains. Let them give glory to the Lord and declare his praise to the coastlands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's read Psalm 112 in unison. Hallelujah. Happy are they who fear the Lord and have great delight in his commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches will be in their house, and their righteousness will last forever. Light shines in the darkness for the upright. It is good for them,
merciful, full of compassion.
It is good for them to be generous in lending and to manage their affairs with justice, for they will never be shaken. The righteous will be kept in everlasting remembrance. They will not be afraid of any evil rumors. Their heart is right. They put their trust in the Lord. Their heart is established and will not shrink until they see their desire upon their enemies. They have given freely to the poor, and their righteousness stands fast forever. They will hold up their head with honor. The wicked will see it and be angry. They will gnash their teeth and pine away. The desires of the wicked will perish.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Those who were scattered because of the persecution that took place over Stephen traveled as far as Phoenicia, Cyprus, and Antioch. And they spoke the word to no one except Jews. But among them were some men of Cyprus and Cyrene, who on coming to Antioch spoke to the Hellenists also, proclaiming the Lord Jesus. The hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number became believers and turned to the Lord. News of this came to the ears of the church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he came and saw the grace of God, he rejoiced, and he exhorted them all to remain faithful to the Lord with steadfast devotion, for he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith. And a great many people were brought to the Lord. Then Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. So it was that for an entire year they met with the church and taught a great many people. And it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. At that time, prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. One of them, named Agabus, stood up and predicted by the Spirit that there would be a severe famine all over the world. And this took place during the reign of Claudius. The disciples determined that according to their ability, each would send relief to the believers living in Judea. This they did, sending it to the elders by Barnabas and Saul. Now in the church at Antioch, there were prophets and teachers: Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, a member of the court of Herod the ruler, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then, after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Jesus said to the 12, "As you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You received without payment, give without payment. Take no gold or silver or copper in your belts, no bag for your journey, or two tunics, or sandals, or a staff, for laborers deserve their food. Whatever town or village you enter, find out who in it is worthy, and stay there until you leave. As you enter the house, greet it. If the house is worthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it is not worthy, let your peace return to you. If anyone will not welcome you or listen to your words, shake off the dust from your feet as you leave that town or house. Truly, I tell you, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah on the day of judgment than for that town. See, I am sending you out like sheep into the midst of wolves. So be wise as serpents and innocent as doves."
The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. I am very happy to be speaking today, connecting with you all by technology across the state of Texas, beamed into your minimalist service. The world in front of the biblical text. The Diocese of Fort Worth, reeling from a legal defeat, a consequence of church conflict that led to a split, with the prospect of impoverishment, or as Paula says, with the invitation to be detached from stuff in a whole new way. Our nation is boiling with rage and demanding justice, seeing something that has been festering there, a wound all along. The coronavirus pandemic is keeping people apart. The church is in diaspora, making it necessary for Bishop Mayer to lay hands on Paula without any of the frills and fun of an ordination. We can't even see our buddies in person. This is the world in front of the text for the ordination of Paula Jefferson to the Sacred Order of Deacons on the Feast of St. Barnabas. And now, the text. Barnabas is remembered by the church for arguing with Paul, always a big temptation, for his liberality in giving, his generosity to the apostles, and for the remarkable name he has been given, Son of Encouragement. Paula wanted to use these propers so that every year hereafter, she could remember her ordination again. In 2007, I was on retreat at the monastery of St. John the Evangelist on the Feast of St. Barnabas. And the superior then, Brother Curtis Almquist, preached a homily that made me feel close to Barnabas ever since. Curtis reflected on his name and the phenomenon of encouragement. He reminded us that encouragement comes from the root word kur, meaning heart, and that encouragement is strengthening of the heart, the giving of courage. And further, Curtis said that courage is not something you attribute to yourself, but that it's something that others see in you. Courage is simply called out from you in a situation that requires you to do what is needed. Paula is also generous. She is an encourager. She is a positive, can-do, heart-strengthening colleague and friend. She used to make the excuse that she was a CPA, and she wanted to make us believe that contemplative prayer or dancing the Easter story, Anglican chanting, and theopoesis were out for her. But she showed courage, and she did those things, and found out that she was wrong. That we have come to this day, that she is actually being ordained at all, is thanks to the encouragement of many, many others, patiently insisting that she had a vocation as a sacramental leader. This cloud of witnesses is represented by the small number with you together physically and with others who pray and support this occasion from a distance. Paula is being ordained a deacon. As a deacon, Paula will interpret to the church the needs and concerns and hopes of the world. She will proclaim to this torn apart world that the kingdom of heaven has come near, that even in the deepest, darkest night of national agony, that the Holy Spirit is moving among us as a force for freedom and healing. She will motivate and enlist the community to cleanse lepers and cast out demons. The deacon says, "Dear church, the world needs racial healing, Dear Church, the world is really worried that the earth may not flourish for human life in the long term. Dear Church, the world hopes for peace and for communion. Now to the future, to the world ahead of the text. First, this ordination tonight is itself a sign that the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, has come near. The liturgical things that a deacon gets to do are pretty simple. Read the gospel, set the table, and give the dismissal. I like to tease newly ordained deacons when they come back to Christ Chapel in the spring semester that there are a lot of ways to mess these up. And we actually witness them all. Garbling the gospel acclamation, pouring the water before the wine, even blowing the dismissal. Go in love and peace to serve the Lord. Serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Or just a stunned silence. Who, me? Paula, it's unlikely that you will mess any of these up. You're too well prepared. Plus, it will probably be a while before you get back to an altar anyway. But it's what these things mean that matters. And Paula, we need you to do them all. But especially today, in this moment, you need to dismiss us well. You need to send us out there to encourage us as we go with a lot less stuff, without beautiful sacred buildings, into a world that yearns to be shown that the kingdom of heaven has come near. Paula, I have a new version of the dismissal for you. It comes from Iyad Qumri, a Palestinian Christian who guided our pilgrimage to the Holy Land a couple of years ago. He had an expression that he always used after he'd shepherded everyone back to the bus, gathered them from the restrooms or the gift shop or the market stalls, and to steer us on to the next holy place. In a voice of utter command and kindness and urgency, he would shout the Arabic word for hurry, Yalla. That's my charge for you today, and your dismissal for us, Paula, after all this time of preparation and encouragement. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Yalla.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. my sister. Every Christian is called to follow Jesus Christ, serving God the Father through the power of the Holy Spirit. God now calls you to a special ministry of servanthood directly under your bishop. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are to serve all people, particularly the poor, the weak, the sick, and the lonely. As a deacon in the church, you are to study the Holy Scriptures, to seek nourishment from them, and to model your life upon them. You are to make Christ and His redemptive love known by your word and example to those among whom you live and work and worship. You are to interpret to the church the needs, concerns, and hopes of the world. You are to assist the bishop and priests in public worship and in the ministration of God's word and sacraments. And you are to carry out other duties assigned to you from time to time. At all times, your life and teaching are to show Christ's people that in serving the helpless, they are serving Christ Himself. My sister, do you believe that you are truly called by God and His church to the life and work of a deacon?
I believe I am so called.
Do you now, in the presence of the church, commit yourself to this trust and responsibility?
I do.
Will you be guided by the pastoral direction and leadership of your bishop?
I will.
Will you be faithful in prayer and in the reading and study of the Holy Scriptures?
I will.
Will you look for Christ in all others, being ready to help and serve those in need?
I will.
Will you do your best to pattern your life and that of your family and or household in accordance with the teachings of Christ so that you may be a wholesome example to all people?
I will.
Will you in all things seek not your glory but the glory of the Lord Christ?
I will.
May the Lord by His grace uphold you in the service He lays upon you.
Amen.
Our souls inspire and lighten with celestial fire. Thou the anointing Spirit art, who dost thy sevenfold gifts impart. Thy blessed unction from above is comfort, life, and fire of love. Enable with perpetual light the dullness of our blinded sight. Anoint and cheer our soiled face with the upper.
God, most merciful Father, we praise you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, who took on himself the form of a servant and humbled himself, becoming obedient even to death on the cross. We praise you that you have highly exalted him and made him Lord of all, and that through him we know that whoever would be great must be servant of all. We praise you for the many ministries in your church and for calling this your servant to the order of deacons. Therefore, Father, through Jesus Christ, your Son, give your Holy Spirit to Paula, fill her with grace and power, and make her a deacon in your church. Make her, O Lord, modest and humble, strong and constant, to observe the discipline of Christ. Let her life and teaching so reflect your commandments that through her many may come to know you and love you, as your Son came not to be served but to serve. May this deacon share in Christ's service and come to the unending glory of him who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Actually, no, wrong.
Nope.
Easy after this.
Paula, receive this Bible as a sign of your authority to proclaim God's word and to assist in the ministration of its holy sacraments. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you.
Thank you. Peace be with you.
Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Yalla.
Thanks be to God. Yalla.